Abigail, what am I going to do?
Do, John?
I need your help.
You don't usually ask my advice.
Yes, well, there doesn't appear to be anyone else right now.
Very well, John. What is it?
The entire South has just walked out of this Congress. George Washington is on the verge of total annihilation. And the precious cause for which I have labored these several years has come to nothing. And it seems that I'm obnoxious and disliked.
Nonsense, John.
That I'm unwilling to face reality.
Foolishness, John.
That I'm pig-headed.
Ah, well, there you have me, John. I'm afraid you are pig-headed.
Well, yes. Oh, Abby. Has it been any kind of a life for you? God knows I haven't given you very much.
I never asked for more. After all, I am Mrs. John Adams. That's quite a lot for one lifetime.
Is it, Abby?
Well, think of it, John, to be married to the man who was always the first in line to be hanged.
The agitator. Why, Abby? You must tell me what it is. Well, I have always been dissatisfied. I know that. But lately, I find that I reek of discontentment. It fills my throat and it floods my brain. Sometimes I fear there is no longer a dream, but only the discontentment.
Oh, John. Can you really know so little about yourself? And can you think so little of me that you'd believe I'd marry the man you've described? Have you forgotten what you used to say to me? I haven't. Commitment, Abby. Commitment. There are only two creatures of value on the face of this earth. Those with a commitment and those who require the commitment of others. Do you remember, John?
Yes, I remember.
Mr. Adams!
Huh?
Are you up there, Mr. Adams?
What do you want?
There's a delivery down here for you.
What is it? Where did it come from? Who sent it?
Compliments of the Concord Ladies Coffee Club and the Sisterhood of the Truro Synagogue and the Friday Evening Baptist Sewing Circle and the Holy Christian Sisters of St. Clair, all for you, John. I am, and I ever was, and ever shall be, yours, 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 yours.
Abigail, what's in these kegs? Buy every damn pin you can find in Philadelphia.
Pin? What sort of pin?
Well, I don't know. Whatever the ladies use for their sewing. Franklin, Jefferson, what are you all sitting around for?
Didn't you hear a word I said before?
Oh, never mind about that. Now, here's what I want you to do.
John, I'm not even speaking to you.
It's too late for that, damn it. There's work to be done. Jefferson, go find Rutledge. Don't come back until you've worn him down. Now, you're both Southern aristocrats. If he'll listen to anybody, he'll listen to you. Franklin, out of that chair. Good as the South if you can't deliver Pennsylvania. Talk to Wilson. Get him away from Dickinson. That's the only way to do it. Go on now, both of you.
John.
Time's running out, damn it. Now move.
I'm still from Massachusetts, John. You know where I stand. I'll do whatever you say.
No. No, you're the president of Congress. You're a fair man, Hancock. Stay that way.